shoe you're talking about. Running your mouth like you know me. You gon' fuck around and chill while the show me. Get caught and show me. Why won't I let you get over me? If you left me with me.
It was my first year starting varsity, and it made me nervous because I knew that I was going to have to try things. You know, I wanted that spot, and I knew I couldn't just be average, that I had to have something that stuck out, and so I knew I was going to have to try things, and I think that's why that quote meant a lot to me.
Out of everything I ever put into the game of basketball, all the practices, that moment right there was worth it.
Since I was in fourth grade, and my stepdad, which the guy that we gave the flowers to on senior night, did you know, he and my mom met because he started coaching me in fourth grade, and he called me and asked my mom on a date, and they've been together ever since.
Plucky. The word literally means courageous, gutsy, spirited. And these 11 girls from a small town in Missouri embody that definition. The lives of these girls were documented for the duration of their basketball season. And after spending 6 months with them, it was apparent. Basketball isn't just about wins or losses. It's about the relationships and experiences players, coaches, fans, and family members all share. But this experience isn't unique to a team from Ashland, Missouri. You may find a piece of yourself in their story. Because sometimes the real game isn't played in the highlights or found in the scores. It's in the players. From the beginning, the Plucky 11 set their goals high.
You're as good as the amount of time you want to put in.
The Southern Boone County Eagles had established a nice run. A 72-10 record over the last 3 years. Expectations were high going into the season. The Eagles won the preseason Centralia tournament, often beating teams by as much as 30 points.
When you're playing schools like Community and Sturgeon, and they, you know, it's like a record doesn't really matter if you're playing schools that are just okay, you know. I mean, it's like there's no point of even driving there.
But the team, with all its talent, was comprised of individuals.
Kim's more of a finesse type player in the sense that she's a little bit more, she's smooth in the sense, not a lot of contact. In the sense that she, when she goes to the basket, she's looking to kind of slide in there, avoid contact.
When the other team tries to like tackle me, especially when we played Fatima and the point guard for Fatima, I think she's, ever since last year, I think she just hates me. I don't know why, but that she tackled me 3 times in like a period of 2 minutes. I was just about ready to hit her. Coach is like, do I need to bring you out, Kim? I'm like, no, I'm fine, it's okay.
I think Blaine and Cora are similar type players in the fact that they're so physically strong, especially when they drive to the basket and can take that contact and still manage to make shots.
Cora and I have been friends since I was like 6 years old, and we have gone through everything, you know, together. She's like my sister. I honestly would tell her anything and expect the same from her.
I've known Jamie since like kindergarten, and we've always known each other and been there. And over like the few years with everything that's happened, like with losing friends and stuff, we've become really close. And I've known Brandy and Blaine for a long time. Blaine's kind of really outgoing, and she's always outgoing, and I think that's what makes her so much different than everybody else. And she's kind of the person, she doesn't care what anybody else thinks.
I guess everybody's pretty like serious sometimes, and I think we're a lot more laid back as a team. Probably a lot of it was because of me. I guess. In some ways, you know, everybody's kind of uptight, but I like to crack jokes, I guess.
I would say Bakes did a lot of the comedy of the team, but I laughed a lot more this year than the rest of the years, but
I don't know, I'm pretty much a comedian, so I guess, you know, she thought that was cool.
Jamie's one of those kids that nobody really notices how hard Jamie works in a game, and she kind of gets overlooked sometimes, but gosh, she makes our team go, and Jamie doesn't have a bad game.
I don't know. I love basketball to death, but I want to do something else with my life, I think, from now on. But I never even wanted to play basketball when I was little. I was like, it never interested me. I didn't play on the playground or anything. And then they're like, well, let's just try it, you know. And when I was in fourth and fifth grade, I was probably like a head or foot taller than everybody else. So it was easy for me because I just stood under the basket.
Ryan is really, I watch her game develop, and I've seen her since she was a freshman, and she's developing into such a good player, especially defensive-wise.
We hung out a lot and stuff, so, and, you know, she kind of looked up to me for, you know, some things, and I gave her advice and stuff, and it's going to be hard, really, on her because she started for us, and she's going to be like, you know, kind of have to take over as far as leadership and stuff goes. So it'll be really hard on her, though.
Blaine has just been there. We have been through so much together. I think she's more like a big sister. That's what she reminds me of. Like, you know that no matter what you go through with her, she's always going to be there.
Brandy. Brandy just makes me smile because it's Brandy.
If I had to pick a person who I know loves to win and maybe didn't get to play as much, I would look at Brandy because I really think she loves to play, is really a focused kid and was always cheering the team on. And
I constantly talk. I don't think there's a day that goes by that I'm quiet. So I think I'm definitely social.
I think I put that in the paper. It says I will deliver. I'll go buy groceries for old ladies. They pay you a lot.
It's like your relationships too with the people that you play ball with, and so when you go in there, you don't play basketball with people you don't like, and I think relationships aren't just about on the floor, but it's off the court too, and if you get along off the court, then I think you're definitely going to get along on the court, and you work better. I think we found out this year that you work better when you get along. You know, this is a long season, so when you're with all these people every day for, you know, hours at a time, you might get irritated with them. And so I think it's just when you get along, it's a lot easier to play. You play a lot better.
Better because each player brought a different ingredient to the mix. But a successful recipe requires more than individual ingredients. It requires one part teamwork and one part unique, laid-back coaching style, different from others in their league. She get it from her mama. She get
it from her mama. She get it from her mama. No, I'm not. I don't really yell at the players. I try and be pretty encouraging. And I think Coach Persinger is the same way. Now they know when I'm mad. I think sometimes you can accomplish that without just screaming and yelling at a player. I'm not a Bobby Knight style type coach, but there are things about his style that I really respect too. A lot of coaches have different styles, and mine is, I don't know, they call it a laid back maybe a little bit, but they, you know, I'm a competitor too.
But when a recipe loses a key ingredient, it can go bad. For the Eagles, a successful basketball season doesn't come without tragedy.
2 days or a day prior to her 17th birthday, and she was driving extremely fast down a gravel road. I wasn't with her, you know, I wasn't anything a part of it, but my mom called me. I was at work that night. She called me and said, you know, Gentry's been in a terrible accident. The helicopters are coming to get her. And the minute I heard helicopter, I knew, you know, it was extremely bad.